Hello guys, so we will be doing a video on the secondary growth. Okay, so we'll be doing secondary growth. Okay, in plants, secondary growth in plants. And first and the foremost thing that we should know is secondary growth takes place in what kind of plants. Okay, first that is the thing that we should be knowing. Okay, so normally secondary growth is going to occur in the dicot stems. Okay, so it is going to occur in the dicot stem. Secondary growth is going to occur in the dicot stems. It is going to occur in the dicot stems. It is also going to occur in the roots of the dicots. So it is going to occur in the stems of the dicots. It is also going to occur in the root of the dicot, and in the case of gymnosperms also you will be seeing secondary growth. Okay, secondary growth can be even seen in gymnosperms. Okay, now what further we should be knowing about it. So in the case of monocotyledons, okay, in the case of monocots, secondary growth is absent. Okay, in the case of monocots, secondary growth is absent, but exceptionally secondary growth is going to take place in some plants. Okay, though it is a monocot, secondary growth is present in some plants like your palm trees. Okay, then we have a tree, a coconut tree, Coccus nucifera, coconut tree, then agave. Okay, so in these kind of plants, okay, what is present in these kind of plants, we have the secondary growth. Okay, pteridophytes and monocots have only primary structure, but in gymnosperms and dicots this starts showing the secondary growth. Okay, but pteridophytes and monocots, they only have the primary growth, but secondary growth is not present. Okay, so now to understand secondary growth we should understand some basics. Okay, to understand the secondary growth there must be some understanding of basic concepts. Okay, so in this video we'll be seeing only the basic concepts of secondary growth. Means to understand secondary growth, what are the basic concepts that are required, that we'll be focusing in this video. Now first thing is secondary growth will be of two types. Not two types, secondary growth when it is occurring, it occurs in the two regions. Okay, secondary growth, it is going to occur in how many regions? Secondary growth is going to occur in two regions. Okay, the first region where secondary growth occurs is called as the stellar region. Okay, it is called as what region guys? It is called as the stellar region. And the second region where the secondary growth is going to occur, it is called as the extra stellar region. What is it called as? It is called as the extra stellar region. So it is going to occur in the stellar region and the extrastellar region. Now to understand what is the stellar secondary growth, you should understand first what is a stele. Okay, now all of you might have studied what is a stele. When you're studying the structure, you might have studied what is a stele. Inner to the endodermis, whatever structures are there, all these structures together we call it as the stele. Okay, now if you see the stele, okay, in the case of dicots, the stele is called as what kind of stele? It is called as eustele. It is called as what stele? It is called as eustele, where the vascular bundles are showing ring kind of arrangement. Okay, where the vascular bundles show what kind of arrangement? The vascular bundles show ring shaped arrangement. Okay, so this is called as the eustele, where it is present in which group of plants? Usually in the dicots. Okay. And atractostyle is unorganized stele that is present in the monocotyledonous plants. Okay. Now, if you're taking one vascular bundle, if you're taking this vascular bundle, okay, and if you're seeing the vascular bundle, we know that the vascular bundle in the case of dicots, the vascular bundle in the case of dicots, okay. We have a meristematic tissue here in between the xylem and the phloem, and this meristematic tissue is called as what? It is called as the intra fascicular cambium. What is it called as? It is called as the intrafascicular cambium. See, intra means within, fascicle means bundle. So because it is the meristematic tissue that is present within the vascular bundle, it is called as the intrafascicular cambium. Okay, and remember, this intrafascicular cambium, it is a kind of primary meristem. Okay, it is a kind of what meristem? It is a kind of primary meristem. Okay, intrafascicular cambium is a kind of primary meristem. This you should remember. Okay, intrafascicular cambium is a kind of what kind of meristem? It is a primary meristem. Now, second thing that you should know is, we have one more term which is called as the interfascicular cambium. Okay, we have one more term which is called as what? Which is called as interfascicular cambium. Okay, see, these are all fundamentals to understand secondary growth. Okay, we have one more term which is called as what? Which is called as interfascicular cambium. Now, understand what is this interfascicular cambium. Now, if you see, in between these vascular bundles, okay, in between these vascular bundles, we have some parenchymatous structures which are called as the medullary rays. Okay, in between these the vascular bundles, we have some parenchymatous structures, and these are called as what? Medullary rays. Okay, now these medullary rays are going to become meristematic. These medullary rays are going to become what? Meristematic. Okay, they're going to become meristematic. So these structures are going to become meristematic. Now, normally they are differentiated cells. Okay, they are differentiated into cells which are the parenchymatous cells. But now what happened? They again got de-differentiated into meristematic cells. Okay, now these cells that are present in between the vascular bundles, these medullary ray cells which are present in between the vascular bundles, after they become meristematic, we call them as interfascicular cambium. Now, why are we calling it interfascicular cambium? Because it is present in between the vascular bundles. So because it is present in between the vascular bundles, we call it as interfascicular cambium. Okay, so I hope these two terms are very clear. The first term is the intrafascicular cambium, and the second term is interfascicular cambium. Okay, so these two terms must be clear in your mind. Okay, again I'm repeating, a cambium that is present inside the vascular bundle is the intrafascicular cambium, and the medullary rays which are becoming meristematic, okay, the medullary rays which are becoming meristematic, and these medullary rays which are becoming meristematic, which are present in between the vascular bundles, we call them as what cambium? We call them as the intrafascicular cambium. Okay, now an important change is going to happen. Now this interfascicular cambium, see, this interfascicular cambium, this one, this is the interfascicular cambium, and this one is the intrafascicular cambium. This one is the intrafascicular cambium, intra, and this is the interfascicular cambium. So together they are joining to form a ring. You see, a ring is formed here, correct? So this ring, which is formed by the joining of the intrafascicular cambium and the interfascicular cambium, this ring is called as the vascular cambium. What is this ring called as, guys? This ring is called as the vascular cambium. Okay, so this is very, very important fundamental concept that you should know in the secondary growth. Okay, so this ring, vascular cambial ring, okay, vascular cambial ring is formed by what and what? It is formed by the intrafascicular cambium plus interfascicular cambium. Together they are forming the vascular cambial ring. Okay, so it is one complete ring which is formed by how many layers of cells? It is made up of only a single layer of cells. This is also important thing. It is not made up of multiple layers of cells. It is made up of a single layer of cells. Okay. Now, next important thing is, if you are seeing this vascular cambial ring, okay, the vascular cambial ring is having primary meristem. Okay, how is it primary? It is having primary meristem because I told you intrafascicular cambium is. Intrafascicular cambium, I told you it is primary in origin, correct or no? So this vascular cambium, some part of the vascular cambium is primary in origin. Okay, it is primary in origin, and some part is secondary in origin. How? See, this interfascicular cambium is formed by the dedifferentiation, correct? So it is obviously what in origin? It is secondary in origin. So part of it is primary in origin and a part of it is secondary in origin, okay? Or it is a secondary meristem, not secondary in origin. It is secondary meristem and this is the primary meristem. It is what meristem? It is a primary meristem. So part of vascular cambium is primary and part of vascular cambium is secondary. Okay. So these are the fundamental things that we should know. So this is the part one of the video. Okay. The next parts are coming.